federal government is really good at making you think you need these encroachments. He said, they said that these encroachments will be clothed with a pretext of necessity. Because you know we have to have federal health care, right? That's what we're here today. You must have national health care. If you don't have national health care, we're all going to die. I got bad news for you. We're all going to die. Death is the only inevitability in life. But national health care simply allows the federal government to decide who, when, where, and how you die. Not only will we be clothed with the pretext of necessity, we'll find the federal government arguing that these encroachments will be disguised by the arguments of expediency, because you know you have to pass the bill so you can read the bill, right? All this sounds familiar to you. Can I remind you that these were the words of state legislators in 1799, not 2017? Why? Because human nature never changes. There is nothing new under the sun. And those who do not know their history are doomed to repeat its mistakes. They must guard the sovereignty of the state. So, now that we know the federal government is stealing our state power, we know that our state and local governments must defend the sovereignty of the state, what do they need to do? Right? I mean, we know, how many of you recognize now we have a big problem? How many of you see it's a little bit bigger than maybe we thought it was when we walked in the room here today? Okay? So fine, I would be really negligent if I didn't tell you how to fix it. And right, it's not me telling you, it's actually James Madison telling you. James Madison says, in the case of deliberate, palpable, and dangerous exercise of other powers not granted, the states have the right to interpose. Now that word interposition means very literally step in between. And Madison says the states have a right to step in between the federal government's exercise of their power to defend the rights and the liberties and the authorities of the people. They have a right to do that. Why do they have that right? Because the power has been reserved. But look at this. Madison says not only do they have the right, they are duty bound. Can we all agree that a duty is greater than a right? Your state and local governments have a duty to tell the federal government you can't exercise that power here. Why do they have that duty? Because we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal and endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights. And that to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just power from the consent of the governed. What governments were we talking about here? The states. The only reason we created the states on July 2nd, just one reason, was to secure our rights. It's the single purpose for the existence of your state and local government. And if your state and local governments are not defending the power that has been delegated to them, they are not securing their right, your rights, and they are failing to accomplish the single purpose for their existence.
Amen.
And then I have to ask you a very important question. Why do we have them? Why do you have a state and local government if they're not doing the only thing they were created to do? Why don't we stop fooling ourselves and stop paying them and just become a federal kingdom, and then we'll know how to fix problems. And we won't be relying on people who try to deceive us anyway. How does the state interpose? What are they supposed to do? They're supposed to interpose. How do they interpose? Thomas Jefferson explains how interposition is supposed to work. The several states, remember not few, but separate and independent, states who formed the Constitution being sovereign and independent, have the unquestionable right, because their power is reserved, to judge of its infractions, and they are the creator of the Constitution, so they have the unquestionable right to judge of its infractions, a nullification by those sovereignties. Who are the sovereignties? A nullification by those states of all unauthorized acts is the rightful remedy. What is nullification? Nullification is the states just simply looking at the federal government and saying, you stole our car, We're taking the keys back. Your authority is void of power, which means it has no force here. The states, that is, nullification is a state defending its sovereignty, saying that power is reserved to us, not delegated to you. Nullification is the right of the states to exercise their reserve powers and their duty to protect those reserve powers. Nullification is not the rejection of all government and the commission of violence against government officials. That's the difference. Nullification is the peaceful remedy and the peaceful control of federal government out of control. Can the Supreme Court deny the states their rightful remedy? Can the Supreme Court simply say the states cannot nullify? Well, I mean, I think that sounds natural, but how about if we ask James Madison? James Madison said in 1800, "If the decisions of the judiciary be raised above the authority of the sovereign parties to the Constitution." Who are the sovereign parties to the Constitution? Well, let's read it like that. "If the decisions of the judiciary be raised above the authority of the states, dangerous powers not delegated may not only be usurped and executed by other departments, but the judicial department also may exercise or sanction dangerous powers beyond the grant of the Constitution. Consequently, the ultimate right of the parties to the Constitution," who are? "The ultimate right of the states to judge whether the compact has been dangerously violated must extend to violations by one delegated authority as well as by another, by the judiciary as well as by the legislative or the executive." James Madison is reminding us of some very important things. Number one, the states created the Constitution. Number two, when the states created the Constitution, they created the federal government. They are the creators of the federal government. Number three, they created the federal government in three branches: legislative, executive, and
judicial.
Which means the only power the judicial branch holds is the power that the states have delegated to it. Which means the states are the higher power and the judiciary is the lower power.